Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Newton's Panthers going up against Dak Prescott's Cowboys.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get him into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal gain.
And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? Elliott. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. Faced with their first third down conversion opportunity and able to punch it through and pick it up on the ground.
And to me, doing it on the ground sends a different type of a message than throwing the football. And, you know, let's face it, we've done a lot of games together. How often have we seen third down turn into an automatic passing down no matter what the yardage?
Yeah, and last thing you want, that opening drive to go 3 and out. You got everything scripted, lined up. Let's get some points on the board, and they're able to avoid that 3 and out. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Play clock winding down. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Elliott, toss right. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be 4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. Running with Elliott. Spinning away. And some space here. Give him 8 on the gain there. And it'll be a Dallas 1st down.
Oh, 4th and short, right at midfield. This is where you tell your offense, I've got faith in you guys to get me a few yards. And sure enough, they repay that faith and keep the drive moving with a 1st down.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. A 1st down carry by Elliott. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him 1 yard down to the 43.
A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Well, this is caught by Williams. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. So here we go, first and 10 now. They'll try the sweep with Elliott. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Oh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. A second down throw for Prescott. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Thomas Davis able to use that strength and get him for a loss of 2. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a 3rd and long here. And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on 2nd down. Third and long for Prescott. Over the middle, complete. That's Brown. And he's going to have a 1st down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Give to Elliott running left. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
The running game's played a huge part in getting them down to this point on the field. I say stay with it. Keep pounding the football. Keep driving. Keep grinding.
Yeah, even down in the red zone, keep going for it.
No doubt about it. Dance with what brung you.
Take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And they will line up now for the 2-point try. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he will get in to make it 8-0. Well, I guess the opening drive touchdown wasn't enough. They wanted 2 instead of 1 on top of that.
Well, this team is obviously going for the crusher. All right, they don't want to mess around with just kicking the standard extra point and kind of letting you off the hook for giving up a touchdown. Now they want to really rub your face in it and say, guess what? We're going to be doing this all game long.
Bailey now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. They go play action with Stewart. Now Newton steps away to his left. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
On 2nd down, they run with Stewart. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a 1st down, keep the sticks moving.
Now Newton on 1st down. Throw left side, complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. Two minutes to play here in the 1st half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the 2nd half. But right now, I think they're just trying to get some momentum built. Get a 1st down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up 2nd down. Well, with that incompletion, a chance to discuss the Pro Bowl happened January 28th, just a few miles from your house there in Orlando.
Yeah, how about that? A lot of excitement, a lot of enthusiasm for the Pro Bowl. You do hear the critics talk about it, but for a lot of NFL fans, closest they're going to get to an NFL game. They love to go to this one, support their team, of course, support the league. It's a lot of fun for them. Even though it rained during the game this time, fans still had a good time.
AFC won 2nd consecutive year. In the 2nd year, it's been held in Orlando. After all those years in Hawaii, I'm still getting adjusted to that.
Yeah, I think we all are. The players are. But those with families, they're having a great time bringing them to all the things that you can get in the Orlando area for your kids.
3rd and long. It's Newton. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. They convert on 3rd with a gain of 22. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 12 more yards there and another 1st down. Now the Panthers going to use the 1st of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this 1st half. Down, Newton Funches has it complete and down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another 1st. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And the seemingly endless drive continues. Down. Here's Newton. They'll set up the screen for Stewart. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the 1st half. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get three before half. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Gano's kick is right through. And they get on the board, trailing now 8-3. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And out now come the Cowboys. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final play of the half, Prescott being chased out left, and they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. This is Stewart again, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
They'll try the air now with Newton. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Throwing on third down, Newton. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Short throw pick six right there, those linebackers. They love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he'll get nothing out of that one. And he is not going to get in there. He stops short of the goal line, and the lead is going to stay right where it is. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. Defense showing blitz. They start on the ground. This is Stewart on first. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. From the gun, here's Newton. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Shepard. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On first and 10, Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jamarcus Lawrence in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Here's Newton now on second down. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. So third and 5, third and medium here. Draw play as Newton gives to McCaffrey. He will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. To throw on second down is Newton. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Tyrone Crawford in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Back now in Arlington. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter of play. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. Here's Newton. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
Desperation time. Newton, fourth down. Airing it out for Olsen. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jeff Heath. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games. And now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
This is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. For just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll pitch it out to Elliott. And he spins through. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 36. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.